Ah, man. You know who doesn't have to wait? Are the illegal immigrants that are on their way here.
Yeah, the caravan is on its way.
Some 8 to 12,000 people, which is great. A migrant activist group representing the caravan is calling for the Biden administration to honor its commitment.
Okay.
Here they come. Migrant rights group Pueblo Sin Fronteras issued a statement on behalf of the people participating in the first caravan of 2021. We recognize the importance of the incoming government of the United States having shown a strong commitment to migrants and asylum seekers, which presents an opportunity for the governments of Mexico and Central America to develop policies and a migration management that respect and promote the human rights of the population in mobility.
That sounds good.
What? We will advocate that the Biden government honor its commitments. And you know what? He probably will. Joe Biden probably will honor the commitments that he's made to illegal alien non-citizens who are blatantly telling the world we're about to spit in the face of all Americans and their bullcrap laws. We don't care about them one iota. We're going to do whatever we want to do. You know, while so many Americans, millions, are suffering without jobs right now because of the freaking shutdowns, Joe Biden will more than likely allow 8 to 12,000 people to flood across our border and demand that they be given one of the most precious gifts on this planet, United States of America citizenship and everything that comes with it. He's going to give it to them. They'll demand that they receive health care and a free education, that they get jobs, places to live. They want homes. They want their relatives to be allowed to come in as well. They'll bring in whatever baggage with them that they have, and we won't know anything about them except that they bring intense poverty, some diseases, no doubt, including COVID-19. In some cases, gang activity. But don't worry about it. Biden will welcome them and give them everything they want.
But do they, seriously, I mean, is Biden sending signals? I mean, why would you blame Biden for any of this? It's not like they're referring to him by name
they actually are.
On their way northward, they're actually saying
yeah.
His name. They're not just coming actually here coincidentally around January 20th. Name.
Yeah, let me show you one immigrant talking about somebody by name.
Okay, well.
Helping us get to the U.S. Cut 7.
What do you want for your people?
What I want for my people, I just want patience and peace that we can get to the U.S. because they're having a new president. Where's Biden? He's going to help all of us. He's given us 100 days to get to the U.S. and give us legal mental paper so we can get a better life for our kids and family.
Okay, great. All right.
Perfect. Well, then I stand corrected.
So, yes, he has specifically apparently told them, I'm giving you 100 days to get here. I don't remember that speech.
That's what I was going to say.
Okay.
Like, wait a minute. This guy's got more information than us. What is this 100 days thing?
All right, I'm giving you 100 days to get here. And if you do, all your dreams will come true. I will make everything happen for you. Don't worry about it.
I'm looking this up because he's referring to something. He's giving us 100 days.
That's unreal. Can you imagine this? In the midst of this pandemic that they're so freaked out about that they harp on every single day, all day. And now you're just going to allow 12,000 people. We have no idea about their health status. We don't know where they've been. We don't know where they're going. We don't know what they're doing. We don't know what they've been exposed to. Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Ollie, Ollie, all come free. That apparently was the cry of Joe Biden after he won the election. You see a 100-day thing? He's top. I think they probably conflated that with the first 100 days of my administration. And now, that means that they have 100 days to get here.
I got news for you, brother. You got more than 100 days.
Oh, yeah.
Take your time, man.
Right.
Sightsee along the way. But his day one promise on immigration is send a bill to Congress on day one.
Day one.
quote, for legislative immigration reform that will modernize our immigration system, end quote. Oh, I'm sure it will.
Yay! Yeah, it'll modernize it. It'll make 11 million people citizens. That's what he wants to do, and there's nobody that can stop him right now. Who's going to stop him? All 11 million that they continually talk about when we know darn good and well. It's more like 20 million, 25 million illegals that are here. They've been using the 11 million figure since I was in Houston. In 2005, they were talking about 11 million people.
Yeah, that's a static number. Come on.
Like it's never changed.
Yeah.
In the last 16 years, still 11 million people.
Yeah, they just get here and that number stays. In fact, they don't even procreate, Pat.
No. So. We know that not to be true.
What?
Don't we? Yeah.
I don't even know what you're talking about.
From Kara 3022. Anyone else notice these oppressed refugees seem to have pretty nice clothes, shoes, and yes, cell phones? And I don't know, some of which cost them $1,000.
You know what? That video we played of that migrant guy coming up here. Yeah, Joe Biden says we got 100 days. Let's go. Let's go. Come on, guys. The longer version of that interview, he goes on to say, it's tough without internet access along the way be able to keep in touch with my family back home.
Yeah, well, it would be, right?
So I don't know if he just doesn't have a roaming plan.
So their 4G doesn't work well?
Right. He doesn't, that's what you're going to do. Before you head north, you got to make sure you've got roaming in the Central America roaming plan.
Well, I think that's one of the promises Biden made to him. I will make sure that your phones affordable roaming plans. And not just this crappy 4G stuff. We're going to give you the 5G treatment, and that's guaranteed.
And if I see LTE pop up on my phone, I'm throwing it into the sea.
And I want it replaced right now by America.
Yeah, and I was about to say, Joe Biden says, but you got to get here first. Well, that's not so true. We'll send the money overseas to plenty of countries to invest in their own infrastructure.
That's really inconvenient for them if you make them wait till they get here. That's, a week or two from now? Stop it. No, they must be reimbursed immediately.
Can we just like do a flyover and parachute some smartphones down to them as they're making their way?
I think that's too dangerous. I think the plane needs to land. Somebody needs to deliver all that stuff by hand to each of the individuals.
Wait.
That have been wronged as they're seeking asylum here in the U.S.
If the plane's going to land,
maybe
they should just get on board and fly back with the pilot.
Maybe.
Instead of just walking through the mountains and
stuff. Yep. Let's see. From Attack Yuki, imagine walking from Honduras to the U.S. to escape poverty and corruption, only to arrive and find poverty and corruption.
Welcome home.